Hello students, now let's have our science class. Today we will start a new chapter, our universe chapter 10. You all know that we live on Earth. Earth is our mother planet. Whenever we see over our head in an open place, we can see the vast sky, that is the endless space. And our Earth is a moving planet in the space. As the Earth moves, we experience day and night. Why? Because of sun. Sun is the source of light in our Earth. You know, as the Earth moves around the Sun, the part of the Earth which faces the sunlight experiences day. And then the opposite part experiences night, because that part don't get light. As the Earth moves slowly, the dark part faces the Sun. So daylight emerges, and the before lightened part become dark gradually and have night. In this way, day and night occur in our planet. Besides Earth, there are many planets which revolves around the Sun. Not only planets, there are many more objects which are continuously revolving around the Sun. These all are included in the solar system. You know, the solar system means the system of the Sun, or you can say the family of the Sun. It contains the 8 planets, their satellites, some dwarf planets, small planets known as asteroids, millions of meteors or shooting stars, and comets. The Sun provides heat and light to the solar system. You know, the planets, their satellites, and other heavenly bodies remain within the solar system due to the Sun's great gravitational power. Actually, the Sun has a great power, the gravitational force, which attracts all the planets and their satellites and other heavenly bodies. An interesting fact is that many much solar systems are located in other galaxies. Now, what is galaxy? A galaxy is a huge collection of gas, dust, and billions of stars and their solar systems. A galaxy is held together by gravity. What is gravity? As I told before, gravitational force through which heavenly bodies which revolves in the space attracts each other. Our solar system belongs to the Milky Way, that is Akash Ganga galaxy. And the Akash Ganga galaxy is in the universe. Okay, and what is the universe? The universe began with the Big Bang, which happened some 15,000 million years ago. This Big Bang created a hot bubble of space, which astronomers have proved is expanding ever since. And you know, astronomy is a subject which called us about the space, which make us known about the space. The study of space is called as astronomy. And astronomy is a study of mystery. And now the universe. The universe is made up of matter and space. Matter is found in the form of innumerable stars, millions of galaxies, planets, and solar systems. And space is infinite. That means never ending in the universe. You know, as we always look up to see these stars and other forms of matter, we feel that heaven is somewhere up there. That is the reason why all the objects in the sky are either called heavenly bodies or celestial bodies. And our universe is ever evolving. And scientists believe that it is getting larger and larger. In fact, our planet Earth is just a little speck of matter in this vast universe. Now, the solar system. The word solar system refers to the sun and all the objects that travel around it, as I told you before. These are planets, natural satellites such as the moon, asteroid belt, comets and meteoroids. The sun is the center of the solar system, which holds 8 planets and countless smaller objects in its orbit with its gravitational force. So I told you, as the solar system is the family of the sun and its 8 planets. You know, there are 8 very important members of the sun's family. The solar system, sun's family is called as the solar system. In order of distance from the sun, there are Mercury, first, it is called as Bud, Venus, Shukra, Earth, Prithvi, Mars, Mangal, Jupiter, Brihaspati, then Saturn, Sunny, Uranus, Arun, and Neptune, Varun. Okay. And you know that Pluto was earlier considered as a planet, but now it comes in the category of dwarf planet. In 2006, the International Astronomical Union, that is IAU, an organization of professional astronomers, decided to reclassify Pluto as a dwarf planet, along with Aries and Ceres. Actually, they all orbit the sun and are roughly spherical, but they are not large enough to be put into the regular planet category. For that, Pluto is called as dwarf planet now. And you know, the word planet means wanderer. As all these planets wander or revolve around the sun on a fixed elliptical path, known as orbit, so that they are called as planet. Okay, clear to you? The four planets closest to the sun are Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars are called the terrestrial planets because they have solid rocky surfaces. Okay, the two outer planets beyond the orbit of Mars, Jupiter and Saturn, are known as gas giants, as they are made of gases like hydrogen and helium. And the more distant planets, Uranus and Neptune, are called ice giants. Uranus and Neptune are called ice giants. Okay, the Earth is the third planet from the sun. Our home planet Earth has certain attributes which make it different from other planets. You know, 2/3 of the Earth's surface is covered with water, and its atmosphere contains a high amount of oxygen, and biologically and geologically alive, the Earth is a dynamic planet. And the Earth is the third planet from the sun. It was formed somewhere around 4.54 billion years ago and is the only planet known to support life. As I told you that among all the planets in our solar system, Earth is the only one which supports life, because here in this planet the balance of temperature is perfect for sustaining life. And you know, the rays of the sun take about 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the Earth. This heat and light are essential for life on Earth. Otherwise, our planet also will be the same as others, where is no life. And you know that the axis of the Earth is inclined at an angle of 66.5 degrees. It takes 23 hours 36 minutes to complete one rotation, and it takes 365.2 days to complete one revolution. Around 365 days and 6 hours it is to complete one revolution. And this rotation, for the rotation here causes day and night on Earth, here on Earth causes day and night, and for revolution we experience the season changes. Okay, so it is all about the solar system. The sun is the center of the huge solar system, and it attracts other bodies with its strong gravitational pull. As a result, all the 8 planets and all the moons and comets remain within its domain, within its family. The sun revolves all them around its own. Okay, so this much for today's class. I think this part is all clear to you about the solar system. What is the solar system? You all try to memorize the planets in the solar system. Okay, and in my next class I'll tell you about the structure of the earth. Okay, so you all stay safe, and till my next class, bye.